Hi, I'm Chris Cinco, User Experience Designer for the Visual Studio Online Monaco project. In this video, I'm going to do a brief walkthrough of our hosted development environment. At the top is the nav bar. It provides links back to the Azure and Visual Studio management portals. And if Git is initialized, it also provides a nice branch switcher. On the left is the activity bar. It provides a clean separation of concerns for your development workspace: Explore, Search, and Git. We also place global commands on the bar for easy access during development. The activity bar does provide status indicators based on what's going on in your workspace. For example, with Git enabled, we keep track of pending changes as you work. And as you can see, all changes are auto-saved, but don't worry, you can still undo or redo. In Explore, you can find all your files and folders. You can right-click files in the tree to execute commands. For instance, you can easily compare two files and show the differences between them. Here I'll just pick the index.jade file and compare it against the layout.jade file. You can also find additional commands on the toolbar towards the top, such as collapse all. To move files around, you can either copy-paste or simply just use drag and drop. On this site, I'm going to start consolidating all the logo images. I also have more of my own, which I can upload files through drag and drop from my machine, like this cool mountain. You can also upload through the upload action on the folder or from the toolbar. With search, you can quickly find strings or tokens across your workspace. Here we do a basic search for box sizing. We can apply other filters to the search as well, such as only showing results that match the whole word, or scoping the search to only CSS files through the file types option. Search results are grouped by file and include a snippet of the line the term is found on to provide more context. So far, I've made a bunch of changes since we've started. As I mentioned before, when Git is enabled, we can keep track of pending changes that you can view in the Git activity. In the editor, commands are also executed through right-click or the toolbar at the top right. Here we have a JavaScript file that is a bit messy. We can simply select all the text, then select Format to beautify the code. With that change, we can quickly compare the deltas against the last commit through the toolbar action Switch to Changes view. You can view the diff side by side or inline if you prefer. Now, one of the best ways to navigate within Monaco is to use Quick Open. You can bring up Quick Open by pressing Ctrl E or clicking on the global command in the activity bar. Let's search for all the CSS files in the workspace and open the first one that comes up. If we want to jump back to the previous file, we can press Ctrl Q. If we want to cycle through the navigation history, continue to hold Ctrl down after pressing Ctrl Q, using Q to cycle through. You will also see your recent history when bringing up Quick Open for the next time. There are also several options to configure the look and feel of the environment in the settings menu at the top right of the nav bar. We currently have two themes, light and dark, similar to those in Visual Studio. You can also hide and show the sidebar if you prefer. There are even more options available in the settings file. You can access this file from the settings menu or settings folder in the file tree. For example, we can hide and show line numbers in the editor by simply switching the value from true to false, with the changes reflected immediately. For additional help, you can show and search through all commands available through the help menu or by hitting F1. You can also bring up the Quick Start guide to give you quick tips about the environment and a link to our other Channel 9 screencasts. That wraps up our walkthrough about the development environment. Try it out, send feedback, and let us know what you think. Thanks!